What's behind a fresh wave of enthusiasm for crypto? It's something called decentralized finance, DeFi for short, that looks more like traditional banking than anything crypto has come up with yet, but it also looks nothing like traditional banking. And it has its own fresh set of jargon to master. I'm going to explain why everyone is talking about yield farming, and another buzzword that people are really losing their minds over, liquidity mining. If all of this sounds a little frothy, don't worry, I'm a bit skeptical too. First, let's go over some history. For a long time, making, or losing, money in crypto was solely a matter of speculating on the price of assets like Bitcoin and Ether. Then, a bunch of people built software on top of the Ethereum blockchain that kind of acted like banks, but without bankers. You could now take a loan out against yourself. No paperwork, no ID, no credit rating. All you had to have was Ether to use as collateral. Put up some Ether, and you'd get dollars, or dollar-pegged stablecoins, in return. That was the innovation that put MakerDAO on the map. Fast forward a few years, and now Compound is one of the major DeFi lending platforms. A new chapter began on June 15, when Compound started giving out governance tokens, called COMP, to both depositors and borrowers. On Compound, people were already earning money for making deposits that other people could borrow. Borrowers were paying interest in order to borrow. That's all normal. Earning interest on deposits was an example of what people call yield farming. Because Compound wanted people on both sides to borrow more and deposit more, it announced it would distribute a new token, COMP, to both borrowers and depositors. The Compound team has a good reputation, and suddenly everyone wanted this governance token, but there was hardly any available on the market. This caused the token's market cap to spike above $800 million in June, before falling back to about $350 million at the end of July. At certain points, COMP was worth enough that borrowers were actually making money off taking out loans. That's how crazy it was. Soon, other DeFi projects started imitating Compound. Balancer created a governance token. Yearn.finance did too. Everyone expects two other buzzy projects, Curve and Ava, will release governance tokens as well. Either way, this idea of giving someone a new token for doing something you want them to do, that's liquidity mining. It's important to be careful in this space. For now, the mechanisms driving DeFi enthusiasm are circular, and ultimately speculative in nature. Also, committing assets to these projects really just amounts to trusting your money to a computer program. Mistakes are made. In March, MakerDAO, the DeFi giant, got tricked into selling $8.3 million worth of depositors' Ether for $0. Despite that failure, DeFi has been growing fast. The next big development could be mainstream investors taking notice. That's happened before. In 2017, it was ICOs, or initial coin offerings, a crypto capital raising mania that drove prices to new heights and brought in new investors. The fallout from the subsequent crash was painful. As an innovation, DeFi makes sense. Bitcoin let you store money and transact it electronically, without a bank or a government. DeFi is building banking functions like lending and interest on top of that, also without banks. Whether the enthusiasm for it is justified comes down to a question of whether this novelty can change the landscape of finance in the near term. If not, it's another wave crashing on the beach, possibly leaving the tide of monetary innovation a little higher than before.